Life is fantastically diverse. Creatures come in so many different sizes, shapes, and colors. Some complex, and some seemingly simple. Almost all these creatures, big and small, are made of the same building block. The cell. Your body is made of many cells, with different functions to allow you to move, to see, and to fight diseases. But all organisms start simple, as a single cell. Some remain as one, others have this single cell divide many times to form a multicellular organism in a process called embryonic development. A single cell somehow contains all the information to generate a whale, a tree, or me. How do cells know to become my finger or my eye? When I studied biology, I learned that the single cell first forms a clump of cells that then gets divided into different regions to form the head, the chest, and the tail. Instructions for this process are in the DNA of cells, telling them what to do and when to do it. Where do these instructions come from? When did they arise? Before there were plants, fungi, and animals, there were only single-celled organisms. Millions of years ago, some organisms must have gone from this to this. How did this transition happen? How did we become multicellular? This is a very broad question, so we need to break it down into a number of smaller questions. We expect that there were single cells who occasionally came together to form colonies of multiple cells, before separating again to survive on their own. These single cells were already quite complex, with an extensive toolkit in their DNA to survive on their own and to collaborate with other cells in the colony. The more cells in the colony became dependent on each other, the more important this division of tasks would have become. So much so that eventually it would have become encoded in the DNA of these cells. Then, when a cell in the colony divides, the new cell immediately knows what to do. Eventually, a single cell could have recreated the entire colony with all its different functions. This would have been the first embryonic development. How did this transition happen? And what did this first embryonic development look like? So we expect that old tools in the DNA of single cells became adapted to do something new in the process of embryonic development. This primitive embryonic development eventually evolved into a more complex embryonic development like our own. Organisms had to evolve new ways to divide this early clump of cells of the embryo into more and more different regions, so that cells in these regions could take on more and more different functions. They also had to do that reliably, in the same way in every generation, always starting from a single cell. To research this, I can't wait for the millions of years it took to evolve embryonic development. Luckily, nowadays, we can simulate embryonic development and evolution in the computer much faster than it would have happened in real life. What does computer evolution look like? We can create an individual that starts out as a single cell that contains computer DNA. This computer DNA are the instructions on what the cell has to do. We will have a bunch of these individuals in the computer that grow, create children, and die. Some of these individuals develop better than others and can create more offspring. These children will inherit the computer DNA of their parents, but occasionally mutations occur that change their instructions so that they can develop differently. Some of these children are better at developing than their parents. And so evolution eventually leads to better and more complex developmental instructions. We expect that our simulations first evolve instructions that are not very reliable, but that improve reliability over evolutionary time. We can also use these simulations to study how old tools in the DNA become adapted to do something new. When we think about life, we tend to think about the big stuff. Trees, whales, ourselves. But our origins are surprisingly small and surprisingly complex. We evolved and developed from a single cell.